Hello, in this short video I'll show you how easy it is to install Kali Linux on a Windows machine. In my case, yeah, I will use OCA to do that, and I will use also Commando-VM that was previously installed on this machine. Okay, so I'll continue with all the step by steps, yeah, that I have also described into my blog on learnoca.cloud. I'll copy this, I'll go with a command line. PowerShell, where it is run as administrator. I can open another one, so to be, let's say, everything from zero. Right click, Windows PowerShell. Okay, and what I need to do in here, by pasting this command, I will enable Windows subsystem for Linux. So I'll be able to install any subsystem, any Linux that I have as a subsystem on that. First thing that will happen right now is gonna do a restart of the server, without any prompt and anything, so be prepared for that. And after that, after the machine has started, and it should be very fast, the start of this machine, as you can see. After the server started in here, if I go to the server management, and I'll look at the local server, or if I'm gonna click in here, manage, okay, and in here add roles. It's still collecting, so let's wait a few more seconds. Okay, if I go next, okay, if I go in here on the features, I have Windows subsystem for Linux installed. Okay, so I'll press cancel this time. Next part that we need to do is to invoke a new URL. That I should have it in there. So in here, administrative PowerShell. Okay, so go with this one. If you have the blog open, you can copy the command from there. So in here, it should be something like this. I'll open a notepad++. This is the command, invoke web request and get Kali Linux from there. I'll put it and I'll invoke the command. Okay, this is gonna take a few seconds. Okay, maybe more like a minute because of the size of the file. So I'll pause it until I'll have all the file, and I'll resume it with the last steps. Okay, so it looks like the web request for Kali Apex finished. Next command that we have to go and paste it in here is this one. Okay, so in here add a package kali.apex. Okay. So now it's processing also this command, so that was very, very fast. So now, if we're gonna press on start menu, you're gonna see that we have a Kali Linux icon. Click on that one. The installation of this Kali Linux started. This one is gonna be much faster than pulling the image from the internet. Okay, anyway, I will also pause it until it's finished. In here you can put your own. Username and password. I haven't pause it, so it's good because you also find it from the beginning. So now, because I'm already connected in here, let me do an update of the machine. Okay, so sudo apt upgrade, and after doing that, what we need to do in here, maybe I want to connect on an SSH server, and also maybe I want to start a desktop. I want to see the desktop, so I'll have to install additional expertise update will finish. I will stop. I can put it in here. I can go and add some additional pre-configured packages, for different regions and so on. I'll pause it because this is gonna take a little bit more. Now that I have updated my system, the next step is to install OpenSSH server, and allow it access if I want to connect to that machine, also with SSH, not directly from the WSL. Okay, so the commands that I need to run right now are these ones. So I will start with installing OpenSSH server now. Okay, paste. Okay, so I need to go to this one, so in here you need to install it, on the Kali Linux. We'll accept it. After that, I need to add port 22 on the SSH config. So I'm gonna wait for this to finish. Okay, so I put this command in here. After that, I will restart SSHD. Okay. I will allow this service to start. And now, again, start SSH. Okay, so now I'm having this service up and running. What I can do in here, I installed previously MobileXterm, so I can go to mobile. I'll start it first time on my virtual machine. Okay, so what I can do right now, if I click create a new connection, I can create another one. But as you can see, I already also have one in here. So I'm connected directly to my MobileXterm machine. Very simple. Okay, so so I have this up and running. Next thing that I want to do in here, maybe I want to use the GUI. So to do that, I need to copy the next commands that needs to be given on this machine. After I'm in there, I'll paste it. Mr. A. So install this one. I'm missing a sudo in front of it. So I will pause it until it's finished. You'll have this prompt first time, so you need to press select the keyboard layout and press OK, and also wait a little bit more for all the GUI, the desktop for the Linux in the backend to be installed. I'll pause it again. Okay, now we have everything finished in there. Next step that we have to do is to define the ports that we want to use for RDP. As you can see, I'm still connecting on the other browser too. So I will copy from this part, our next command. Copy, I can put it in here if I want, or I can use the other one. Take this one, session, rdp, localhost in here. Yeah, the user should be Adi, and the port should be 3390. I'll press OK. Yeah, and to last my password. Okay, and I'll log in. Okay, so congratulations, you're able also to see Kali Linux in GUI right now. Okay, so we can fit this one, then you can start using Kali directly from the commando VM. Yeah, so right now you have a complete offensive machine up running. Thank you for watching.